Hello and welcome to the video of my information operating system. I am Kyle Stratus, and in this video, you'll learn how to effectively read and annotate articles for intake into Rome and what tools you can use to help. You'll also learn how to use Readwise to foster serendipity and act as a bridge to pull all of your notes into Rome. Then, you'll learn how to use progressive summarization and evergreen notes in Rome to supercharge your creative output. First, you'll need to find articles. You might already have sources you enjoy, but you can mine newsletters, books, magazines, blogs, and more. You can collect most of these with the modern RSS reader. I prefer InnoReader because it can collect newsletters for you and seamlessly connects to Instapaper. I do much of my article reading and annotating in Instapaper. Pocket is useful too, but it doesn't have note-taking functionality. To highlight in Instapaper, just select text and click highlight. If you want to take a note, do the same thing, but click the note button and type your note. Once I'm done reading, I like to archive the article to hide it from my reading list. Now that you've seen how to make your highlights and notes, let's look at how to collect them. After creating your notes, you'll want to collect them somewhere. The best somewhere that I found is Readwise. Readwise is a tool that resurfaces your highlights and notes from multiple sources: Kindle, Instapaper, Pocket, Air for annotated podcasts, and more. Every day, you'll get an email or notification if using the mobile app with a selection of your highlights and notes, but the real power lies in it being a single repository for all of your notes. First, this is what the daily review looks like. Readwise does spaced repetition to help you remember what you've read while also resurfacing passages that resonated with you. For me, this has triggered new ideas and helped me link old thoughts via highlights with my current thoughts. This is very powerful. But like I said before, the real power is in Readwise collecting all of your notes in one place. Combine that with its automatic Rome export, and now you've got a pipeline that sends all of your highlights and notes from all your reading tools into Rome with the bonus of a spaced repetition system. This is the Rome Export Preferences page. It is highly customizable with the Jinja 2 templating system, and what you're seeing is my customized template. You can find links to the Jinja 2 documentation, my Readwise template, and a link to an extended free trial of Readwise in the description. Now that your notes are being collected and sent to Rome, it's time to see what to do with them. This is what a freshly imported article looks like. With the Readwise templates, unfortunately, headers aren't automatically interpreted as such. So let's fix that first. This is what your highlights will look like. You might notice a View Highlights link. This is added by Readwise and will take you right to your highlighter note in Instapaper. The first step I usually do is run through the first two parts of progressive summarization as described by Tiago Forte. Tiago recommends doing this slowly over time, but if you consume a ton of articles, it might be worth doing it all in one fell swoop, especially if you use something like the Idea Factory, where the bulk of your synthesizing happens in a writing inbox. First, you'll bold the important points. If you have any notes from Instapaper, those appear nested under the associated highlight. If it's a general note, drag it to literature notes. If it's an idea, drag it there. Then add a block reference from the original highlight underneath the note. Next, add a highlight to any bolded points that are especially poignant. While you're doing progressive summarization, you might get new ideas or inspirations, things that will grow up to be actionable projects. For me, these can be article ideas, video ideas, research topics, or software projects. Add these in the ideas section. When you've finished writing an idea, add a waiting tag to it. The waiting tag here is useful for later queries. As an example, in my Idea Factory video, my writing inbox holds queries for, among other things, ideas in waiting status. These blocks will show up there for later processing. When processed, you can remove the waiting tag. Now, let's jump to the literature notes. In my template, I have a few quotes that help me remember how to categorize literature notes. These are any notes or commentary that are tightly tied to the literature. They may be a summary of someone else's points, an explanation, or an observation. Once you write your note, add child blocks. These are block references to the highlights that make up the literature note. The goal of literature notes is to note down your independent thoughts, section summaries, and really anything that is tied to the text itself. Feel free to link concepts as necessary. These are tough to pin down and are kind of amorphous, and as you do this, your practice will evolve and change, and that's okay. These notes can serve as references to transient notes. Transient notes are more general, abstract notes. Literature notes are the main sources for these, but the difference between them is that they aren't tightly coupled to the article text. These should be written generally enough so that you could write similar, related transient notes from other similar articles. This is so that you can identify clusters to form into evergreen notes. Writing these is similar to writing a literature note. Add block references as sources underneath the transient note, mostly to your literature notes, but it's okay to directly reference a highlighted block as well. End these notes with waiting tags. Like with your ideas, doing this will allow you to query unprocessed transient notes. Once you've finished processing the article, change the status to processed and remove the things to process link. I also like to add tags for any relevant topics. This helps me fill out topic pages with source articles and generate even more note clusters to transform into evergreen notes. Before finishing up, I wanted to show some finished evergreen notes. These are densely linked, standalone, durable notes on a concept. You can form these once enough transient notes are accumulated describing a similar concept. Once you process the transient notes, you can change the waiting tag to processed, so that way they're out of your writing inbox. You might notice a pattern with the references. These are block references to the transient notes that informed the formation of the evergreen note. Just like transient notes have block references to the literature notes that made them, and the literature notes have block references to the highlights that made them. These are evergreen, but they're not meant to be static. You can add new transient notes as they come up, make contradicting evergreens that have links to these to document the conflict, and update the text as you learn new things. Once you have enough evergreen notes, they can form the basis of any kind of output, like articles, projects, new research topics, and more. To learn more about evergreen notes, check out the book How to Take Smart Notes, as well as Andy Matuschuk's notes, both linked in the description. Jumping back to the article, let's take a look at summarization. The final parts of progressive summarization include writing a 1-2 sentence executive summary on the topic. You can do this now or wait until you use the article again in the future. This template also has a few extra questions to help you think more about the content of the article. In my experience, this helps you have a deeper understanding of the article's main ideas and makes you more able to integrate them with the rest of your knowledge. These questions are, what are the key ideas? How can I apply this knowledge that I learned? How do these ideas relate to what I already know? You don't have to answer every question for everything that you read. Think of these questions instead as a thinking guide. Do you have questions that you like to ask yourself after reading something? Let me know in the comments. In this video, you learned how to use Instapaper to read and annotate articles, how to collect all your notes and periodically review them with Readwise, and how to summarize, distill, and synthesize your notes into knowledge in Rome. And that's it for the information operating system. If you liked the video, please like it. If you didn't, dislike it, and let me know what you thought in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe for more videos and live streams as they come out.